Suhas Raddihe. He is a graduate in electrical engineering and have been actively serving into HVAC and MEP segment for last 12 years. Mr. Suhas is presently associated with Design Engineers as an MEP consultant. Design Engineers is a 32-year-old company. His expertise includes MEP, HVAC, consultancy and project planning. He has also been associated with Ishire as a member. Mr. Suhas will deliberate upon installation guideline, pre-commissioning, testing and commissioning of HVAC systems. So delegates, let's welcome Mr. Suhas.
The classification of air conditioning system. Air conditioning system consists of centralized system and direct expansion system. Centralized system consists of air cooled chiller, water cooled chiller, vapor absorption system. Air cooled system. Air cooled system consists of air cooled condenser, chiller, package unit, chill water pump, air handling unit, and chill water expansion system. Water cooled system consists of water cooled system, water cooled condenser, cooling tower, air handling, chill water pump, chill water condenser, chiller, package unit, and chill water expansion system. Classification of air conditioning system, direct expansion system, uniform refrigeration. The inter unit of direct expansion system and variable refrigeration flows are there are wall mounting units which is called split AC, ceiling cassette unit, one way, two way, three way, four way. There is ceiling cassette unit, which also known as a fan coil unit, ceiling suspended unit, float standing unit, and floor mounting, which is called some tower and as well as an air handling unit. So this is a system of this condensing unit, which are mostly familiar in a building, a residential, where one-on-one system has been provided with one indoor unit system, with one indoor, one outdoor system. And this is a VRF outdoor unit, which consists of a number of windows which can be connected to a single outdoor unit. So to install the VRF system, chill water system, there are certain guidelines. I would like to give some instruction guidelines. So inspection arrival. So after inspecting after arriving of unit, you have to check the number of crates, packages, and the list packages and ensure that they are fully assigned. You have to check any damages are there. If any damages are there, you have to write them on a DVD challenge. You have to also see if any damage, and you have to claim with an insurance company or a transporter. You have to check the items given in a technical specification and a BOP. A BOP consists of technical specification and technical specification BOP would give you a detailed discussion, detail about what are the units to be installed, the location and moment. Ensure that the units are to be placed carefully to avoid damage. Units should be placed such a way that there should not be left with a minimum damage. Units should always be in upright positions. When lifting a unit, in a forklift, you should ensure that no damage from the base strength to the unit power the force. Space requirement. You have to oversee the dimension and data clearance given the ground. And while designing only, we have to see exactly the dimension, data clearance, dimension, data and clearance, so where we have to use the unit. You will have to install in such a way that it will be easily maintenance free and easily accessible. It should be not to be located in such a this is special and outer unit, so not be located to the area which should make a more noise. So it should be avoided and at the most it should be just far away from the far away from the space building. Whether units are installed in immediate or of load or critical application, the acoustic or structural consultants are. Acoustic or structural consultants will be there, so that they would help to for a minimum noise level. They can help us in providing a minimum noise level. Foundation. While foundation, we have to see our installation. We have to see a foundation that all the foundations and the foundation of units can carry that kind of thing. So we have to see all the foundations. We have to give a proper weight. A foundation should be will never have proper operation and function of control. Then vibration isolator. Vibration isolator is can be used for air handling units. It should be installed in chillers, pump, air handling, and water piping. Water piping connection. Installation guiding for water piping connection The location and internet connection of pillars, condensers, cylinders, E2G, as per the drawings and designs. The pipes could be provided with easily removable sections, plans, joints, and cleaning of replacement. Pipeworks can be complete with a suitable provision for air purging and draining of water. All the walls and measuring instruments should be as per drawings and BOP. All the items should be as per the BOPs and technical specifications. So then, what are the pre-commissioning activities? So while we are installing of the chilled water system, water cooled chilled water system, we should ensure that the plant rooms are completely free from the construction of debris. All the plant room doors are to be fitted and lockable. Permanent supply of sufficient capacity is available to plan the operator system. All lazy works are to be completed and windows are to be fitted. All external doors, all stairs, lobbies and toilet doors are to be completely secured so that no infiltration air should be coming. Pre-commissioning activities. All the dust generating activities by other agencies are finished and all the areas are clean and sealed to prevent the increased dust and getting the ventilation. In this case, we should clean the area so that no infiltration or dust particles come to our air system. Air intakes and louvers are being obstructed must be cleared. Air intakes create a lot of dust particles, so it should be properly cleaned before it should be installed. Fan and other equipment chambers shall be given for the construction of the building. The air handling unit fans are kept on the side of the site. So after a few days, it may get adjusted. So it will be properly cleaned before installing the system. The fans are to be set for the interior housing, clearance, and free from the foreign subjects. Pre-commissioning activity, cooling coil. Cooling coil condensing drain tray should be unblocked. There should not be any blockage during the drainage system. Dampers should be completely clean. Ductings, air terminals should also be clean. All electrical wiring, power lighting, controls should be completed during the commissioning period. All electrical panels are to be commissioned and cleaned. Lighting systems are to be switched on. Permanent supply is available to electrical panels and can be connected to each and every switch. All outside air return air dampers should be in operating condition. All fire volume control dampers are to be fitted and left in a fully open position so that our air quantity can be easily adjusted. VAV and terminal should be installed with the grills and valves. Pre-commissioning activity, all the manuals, automatic control valves should be open on a preset as and when required. The valves should be open as per the flows. All the spinners are to be cleaned, white spinners have to be cleaned. All water systems should be flushed out and should be vented out and should be chemically first cleaned out. Chemically cleaned and then you can start. All the filters media should be installed. Plant room access is to be restricted by the authorized person. Unauthorized person should not be entered to the plant room. All functions and safety devices are to be installed and shall be in operation. Specialized equipment manufacturers should commission to be installed. For installation of VRF systems or installation of chiller, expertise in manufacturing should be present at the site so that your commissioning becomes very easy for the system. So these are the few photos of how piping connections have been installed. So what are the testing and commissioning? What are the testing commissioning activities? Testing and commissioning of water piping system. We should see that all the piping should be tested at a test of 10.5 kg per square centimeter. All the pipes should be tested at hydraulic 1.5 times the maximum operating pressure or whichever is higher for the period of 24 hours. All the leakage defects in the joints and piping during the test shall be rectified so that there should be no leakage in gas or water. So all the leakage and defects in the piping should be tested so that there could not be leakage of water. Water piping system, no pipes can be welded when the water is inside. All the welding should have been done before the water has been installed. After installation of water, after welding, we should not weld the pipe after installing the water. Piping repairs subsequent to the upper pressure shall be retested in the same manner. All the weldings shall be done, and we should see that we have to pressure test the pipe. Entire system has to be checked and see that there is no noise circulation of water in the circuit, so that no system. Whatever. After completion of installation, the pipe has to be flushed out through blow out for dirt and mud. After completion of installation, the pipe has to be flushed out throughoutly so that there is no dirt and debris. Commissioning of spreaders has to be used before all equipment. The system shall be balanced to deliver water quantity as specified. No paints and insulation shall be applied to the pipe unless the pressure testing has been completed. So these are the testing and commissioning activities for pump. What are the testing activities of pump? While testing of the activities of pump, we should see the duty point performance. What are the performance efficiency curves we have to see there? Then we have to see the cutoff head test. 5 point performance test. We have to see what is the pump suction pressure, pump discharge pressure, what is the flow of pump, what is the RPM of the pump, and what is the power of the pump. Testing of air handling unit. This is thermal air handling unit. By testing of air handling unit, we have to see that evaporative coil in and out, coil out temperature, we have to check out. Return air temperature at the filter side, we have to check. Supply temperature at the fan discharge, we have to check. Air quantity, we have to check. Pressure drop across the filter and motor current. Ducting. Now, during the ducting, which is a phenolic chrome ducting, inspection and by testing and ducting, we have to see that the ducts, branches, elbows are inspected and joined and connected before the assembly in the position. After assembly, the system should be checked for the air tightness, vibration, and noise due to the turbulence. The system should check that there should not be air leakages, vibrations, and noise. All the angles, jaws, and other MS members, material components for the support should be provided. Handling of ducts. So we have to require the angles of all the joints should be airtight with a proper package gasket and all interior surface shall be smooth. Vent shall be made with a radius not less than 1.5 of the top or with a properly designed curve. Service vents shall be provided with a branch, takeoff and the collar wherever the operation. The connection to the supply fan shall be to make to the flexible connection, flexible double canvas connection should be provided with a 150mm length. The tube shall be secured diagonally and bolted to the duct. After completion of all work, joints shall be visible and inspected for the proper. After completion of, we should see that all the gaskets are properly, we should visualize and see that it is properly gasketed, all the nuts bolts are tight, all the bolts are tight. The entire air distribution shall be balanced. The supplier quantity as required in the zones and room to be maintained in a specific condition. While deciding, we have given a certain air quantity. So we have to, while the entire system has been better, we have to see that the number of how much air quantity does that proper grade give, how much CFM does that room we are getting at that condition. Our ducts should be totally free from vibration under all the conditions of operation. After duct installation, the part of the duct, approximately 5% of duct nerve, should be selected randomly. We have to select a 5% of duct and randomly check for the leakage. The procedure of this test should be followed by the SNAGDA accuracy duct leakage manual. After installation of entire air distribution system completed in all respects of duct and shall be tested for the air leakage by a visual inspection. The entire air distribution shall be balanced under an anemometer and measure air quantity of fan discharge at various outlets. The entire air distribution can be balanced to supply air quantity as required in the various condition states to maintain a guaranteed condition. So we have to entire this entire distribution can be such that there should be uniform balance to get proper cooling in. Branches of the adjustment can be permanently marked after air balancing so that they can be restored. So we have to mark the branch adjustment so that whenever we can restore in a correct position. Thank you.